The phone rings in the middle of the night, and the police inspector of a small Korean village is informed that a woman was murdered by her husband, this man. At the same time, a local herbalist is hunting, when he stumbles, crashing into the rocks below him, bashing his head, and falling unconscious. When he awakes, he finds a man with bright red eyes feasting on the raw flesh of a deer. People start to become sick. Their personalities change. The air grows stale and sinister. More murders happen, as well as suicides, and it soon becomes evident that it is common belief in the village that a spirit has invaded and taken up residence in the sleepy town and is haunting everyone in its domain. Paranoia and crowd mentality soon take hold and is a constant background noise to the police and their work in the film as they try to investigate what is really happening here. What Na Hong Jin has set up here is something really special and rare to find in the horror genre. At nearly 3 hours in runtime, he creates a horrifying meditation on mysticism, religion, xenophobia, trust, respect, family, and ruralism, as he weaves a mystery so complex that to even begin to unravel it, you must take his hand and follow him into the depths of these ideas. It's the kind of movie that to follow it, you have to use logic in which you unequivocally believe in shamanism, otherwise you will be utterly lost in its madness. It asks you to believe that a spirit is in the town, and then asks you to try to apply logic to something that is entirely illogical. And this movie's brilliant for that. It's a slow burn, but it's deliberate in the way that it forces you to think about what's going on under the surface at all times. Because this movie is all about what hides under the surface, and the masks and roles that people wear in their day-to-day lives. Zhang Gu, the inspector, is illustrative of this point. He wears the uniform of a police officer, and plays that role professionally, as he consistently in early scenes scolds others on the force for acting differently. But as a man, he is deeply frustrated by restrictions placed on him as an officer of the law, which makes his descent into vigilante justice all the more interesting. He acts strong, but awakens from horrible nightmares every night, and when scary or supernatural things happen around him, he quivers in fear. The movie constantly shows you a facade of a character only to reveal something extremely conflicting about them, and if the events of the movie are to be taken at face value, then you're not gonna have a good time. Because a crucial thing about this film is that the unnerving, mysterious, invading spirit has the ability to possess people and masquerade as them in the village, leaving you as the viewer and Zhang Gu as the inspector to focus deeply on who exactly is real in every scene, and what can be taken as truth and what should be seen as a deception. The spirit outright lies to you out of the mouths of innocent people, and it's up to you to figure out when these moments are, and who the spirit is at different times in the film. The wailing encourages rewatches to figure out its puzzle, and if you aren't prepared to interact with it in depth, then the way the film plays out may seem really lackluster, and might not make much sense. The film is beautifully shot, well-paced, edited, acted, the costume design is great, and all departments here are firing on all cylinders. And you should watch it just for that alone. But the real reason that this needs to be seen is because of the fantastic script. The film presents you with an ending that isn't really an ending at all, and is more like another piece of the puzzle that ties in thematically with the film. One of the deepest themes woven through the narrative is about xenophobia, and how to properly respect your fellow man and neighbor. The entity that many believe to be the cause of the suffering in the village is referred to colloquially only as the Jap. He is the aforementioned man with red eyes, who allegedly ate the raw flesh of a deer. Zhang Gu has nightmares about him, and he is a lingering presence over the first quarter of the movie in particular. But you slowly realize that each time he appears, it is through someone recanting what was told to them from someone else. Zhang Gu first hears the story of the deer from his partner, who heard the story from an herbalist, and the visuals we see are a secondhand representation of a small town game of telephone gossip, played in a heated climate warped by paranoia. And when we actually see the Japanese man, he is just exactly that. A man from Japan, living in the remote outskirts of the village alone. But we've heard so much of him at this point that we are terrified of him whenever he's on screen, even though he isn't doing anything overtly evil at all. The film, in a hypnosis-like way, trains us to see the situation from the perspective of Zhang Gu, because every scene is from his point of view. And so the movie puts us in the uncomfortable position of being afraid of someone just because they are different from us and we do not yet know them. And it's ultimately trying to say that this is the wrong way to see the world, and that we should not make judgments based on ideas rather than facts. Zhang Gu sees the world this way, and we follow him down a rabbit hole of toxic suspicion, watching him use evidence that he finds to confirm his bias rather than investigating further to find deeper hidden truths. Filmmaker Na Hong Jin is saying that this isn't the way to be. He makes a movie here about a failed investigation into ancient evil, involving archaic magic, shamans, spirits, and demons, and at the end of it all, we are left to pick up the broken pieces of a town so left in disarray that it hardly resembles what we saw at the beginning, and we just have to ask, what happened? It says that the police fail to find a reason as to why this has happened to the town, and that the reason they fail is because they are looking for evidence to fit a preconceived idea that they have of a person, rather than looking at the information presented in an objective way, to take individual pieces of information and see how they fit together with other parts of the story. It's telling the audience to be better, and to look for real and evident truths and not preconceived myths, especially in a world filled with dark magic and ancient esoteric secrets. The conclusions that you come to will probably differ greatly from me, and that's okay, because learning what the film is about is a personal journey that each individual will take, and the point isn't to be right, but instead to wonder. I still don't know who the spirits in the movie really are, and what their true motive may be, if they are even real. And to me, that is deeply more frightening and lasting because it affects me on a deep, primal, emotional level where ghosts and demons lie. I love to think about what things in this movie may mean, and I hope you do too. I have loved Korean horror and folk horror my whole life, and the way that the chaos in this town slowly plays out in the background here is absolutely fantastic. I haven't really ever seen anything like it before, and so I don't know what to compare it to. But if you like a good mystery, then you should just watch it. And let me know what you think, because I'm really curious to see what other people see in this film. The Wailing is a dark movie that slowly creeps up on you and, like The Village, engulfs your senses. It's one of the best films in the genre this decade. There's a base story there, hidden in the subtext. There are many facts, but also unknowable things steeped in enigma, where sometimes magic is magic and the rest is entirely up to conjecture. And that, to me, is a wholly frightening and haunting concept.